后港区的居民，晚上好。 Residents of Hougang, good evening. Tonight, I want to touch briefly on an issue that is close to the heart of many Singaporeans, including Hougang residents. I want to talk about healthcare in Singapore. Most Singaporeans, especially the elderly, worry a lot about falling ill. They're concerned not just about the painful treatment they have to go through, but the painful amount of money they have to spend. They're concerned about the financial burden they may place on their children. But when Singaporeans cry out to the government that healthcare is getting too expensive, the PAP boasts of their 3M's financing framework: MediSave, MediShield, MediFund. They say that this is how the government helps Singaporeans pay for their healthcare expenses. But of the 3Ms, 2 come from your own pockets. The last, MediFund, is only available to the very poor who have used up all their savings as well as their children's savings. Let's talk about the first 2 M's. MediSave is your own hard-earned savings. It is not a gift from the government. MediShield is a health insurance scheme. You pay premiums most of your life, and you can only draw down from it if you are very sick. The government does not subsidize MediShield. In fact, I asked in Parliament how much MediShield has collected in premiums and how much they have paid in claims. Who wants to make a guess? Did they collect more or did they pay out more? Between 2006 and 2010, MediShield collected an average of $131 million more in premiums each year than it paid out in claims. $131 million each year. Because the PAP operates MediShield like a commercial insurance scheme, premiums shoot up as one gets older. So after you retire and have less money on hand, you find yourself paying higher and higher premiums and deductibles. Yet, this is precisely the time when you need more medical care. I had called in Parliament on the government to avoid increasing premiums when they expand coverage, but instead use some of the millions of dollars collected in premiums to fund the schemes. The government has refused. These are complex issues. It is hard to go into details during an election rally. Also, the PAP can choose not to reply to what we say during election rallies. But in Parliament, they cannot ignore us. They have to respond. They must either justify their position or change their policies. This is why we need you to send more Workers' Party candidates into Parliament so that we can fight them for your rights. If you vote Peng Eng Huat into Parliament, he will work with the rest of the Workers' Party MPs to push the government to reduce healthcare costs for the people. Voters of Hougang, this is our last election rally and the last day of campaigning. There have been many distractions during this election campaign, but I urge you to focus on what is important for you and your family. This is a by-election to decide whether you want the Workers' Party to continue serving you in Hougang and representing you in Parliament. The PAP has thrown up a couple of goodies to entice you. Actually, the goodies this time are not as good as in previous elections. They are just promising you a couple of covered walkways, which the Workers' Party is already planning for you. In 2006, They promised you $100 million to upgrade your ward if you voted for them. You rejected the carrot because for you, having a credible opposition voice in Parliament is more important than upgrading. Voters of Hougang, the PAP has punished you for years for voting for the Workers' Party. They used you as a whipping boy to set an example to other constituencies to show them the consequences of voting for the opposition. Now, the PAP is asking the people of Hougang to make a fresh start and vote in a PAP candidate who will work with the government to improve your lives. They tell you that they have always been here for you. Who has been here working for you and working with you for the past 20 years to improve your lives? Not the PAP for sure. They have been working against you to make your lives miserable. So how dare they come here and expect your vote now? The PAP put Hougang at the end of the queue for HDB upgrading. Well, 20 years has passed and we have already reached the end of the queue. The government has promised that all eligible flats, even in opposition wards, will be given this upgrading by 2014. This is just 2 years away. On Tuesday night, Mr. Peng Eng Huat listed out the blocks that the Town Council has nominated for upgrading. So, upgrading is no longer an issue. You will get upgrading, even if you vote for the Workers' Party. With that out of the way, I urge you, voters of Hougang, to think about your future and your children's future as you vote. Hougang has been a shining light of democracy for over 20 years. Do you want to keep it that way? The PAP asks you to vote for change, but a leopard cannot change its spots. You cannot have change if you vote for the PAP. Mr. Desmond Chu cannot pressure the PAP government to change. He is not an independent voice, like he claims to be. He is part of the PAP. If you want change, vote for the Workers' Party. Minister Teo Chee Hien. Keeps implying that our candidate, Mr. Peng Eng Huat, is not the best man for Hougang and that we are taking Hougang voters for granted. But the PAP fielded in this election their worst performing candidate in the 2011 general election. Mr. Desmond Chu got just 35% of the votes. If the PAP is serious about winning back Hougang, why don't they field one of their minister-caliber candidates here? They are so full of talent, aren't they? And there are three ministers who were forced into early retirement last year after they lost in Aljunied GRC. Why not field them instead of Mr. Chu? So tell me, who is taking Hougang voters for granted? We have put forward Mr. Peng Eng Huat because we believe that he is the best man for Hougang. what? But in what understands Hougang residents? He has a track record of serving Hougang residents since 2006. He demonstrated through his actions that he cares for you and he will look after you well. He will speak boldly for you in Parliament. Voters of Hougang, in 2 days' time, when you walk into the polling booth, send a message to the PAP that the people of Hougang will stand tall and will stand proud and will never, never be intimidated by the PAP. Vote for the Workers' Party. Vote for Peng Eng Huat.